So it's come to my attention that a big YouTuber by the name of Mar or Mariale, I could be saying that wrong, I don't know, has basically stolen one of my story times and has uploaded it on her channel and is now monetizing and making revenue off of my story and my experience while working at Sephora. And this whole thing is just very confusing to me, and I don't know what's going on. This person has 2.9 million subscribers on one of their accounts and 13.4 million subscribers on another. So I really just do not understand what is going on. I don't know if she's running out of content. I don't know if she's feeling like she's I don't know what's going on. I don't. But I felt the need to sit down and just talk about this with you guys because I am very much annoyed. I feel somewhat disrespected, and I just don't think this is okay. I don't think this is okay at all. And I'm sure it's been a while since you guys have heard me speak so seriously, but like, I'm irritated. I really am. So I got a bunch of DMs and a bunch of tweets from my subscribers telling me about this person. Outside of today, I've never heard of this person, never seen their face, never seen their video, never heard their name. I've never met someone named Marlena, Marlini in my life. I don't know who this person is whatsoever from anywhere. Let's just get that clear. Because apparently some people thought that this was a collaboration of ours. Not a collaboration. She never reached out to me. We never had a conversation. She never emailed me, never DM'd me. She's not even following me on Instagram, Twitter, not subscribed to my YouTube. I don't know this person from anywhere. But for some reason, this person felt comfortable to literally steal my content, monetize it, and make revenue, make money from my story and my experience. I'm very confused. This is a video I recorded 3 years ago about my experience working at Sephora. I'm sure a lot of you guys have watched it before. It's me basically telling you guys about the time that one of my coworkers ruined a person's wedding, okay? This was uploaded 4 hours ago from the time that I'm recording this video. 4 hours ago. Same title. But not only is it the same title, it's the same story. Like, to a T. Like, word for word. Like, embezzlement. And you guys know that this is not my content on my channel. I don't sit down and stir the pot and call people out and talk about YouTubers point blank period. I don't do that. But I had a decision to make, and I was like, my decision is to stand up for myself because I don't think this is right. Like, this is not right. So when the subscriber sent me this video, at first I was like, whatever. But then I got some time on my hands and I was like, let me watch this. And I was flabbergasted. First of all, my name is Paris, right? And then she came through and said,
so today my name is gonna be London and I work at Sephora.
I don't know about you guys, but that feels borderline taunting to me, as if it's like, you know who you are, you know this is your story, but I'm not gonna credit you because I don't have to. That's how I'm feeling. But now you guys might be saying, well, I clicked on the video and she credited you, so what are you talking about? Well, not only did my subscribers see that I wasn't credited until she got called out, I saw for myself. I was not credited until maybe 15 minutes after I refreshed the page. You need some more receipts? Here they are. She never once in the video said, this is HeyParis's video. She never once in the video said, check out HeyParis's channel. She never once in the video said, this is not my story. Crediting me after you get called out is very weird. It's very weird. Very weird. It's borderline embarrassing. Truly. So if nobody called her out, I would have gotten zero recognition for my life experiences. This whole thing just doesn't make sense to me. She told the story word for word, down to the part where I said I had Chinese food for lunch.
One time I was just chilling. I was having my lunch break, eating some Chinese food. And then Linda comes out and she's like, oh, you only got 5 minutes left. Excuse me, Linda. Why are you out here counting my lunch break?
Like every single detail? Are we serious? Are we being serious right now? Are we? She even said that the customer was a darker complexion than she was.
This is probably a good time to do a small break in the story and tell you guys that both people in the story had a complexion that is much deeper than mine, and that is very relevant.
And this and that and that and this, and none of it was real because it's my story. So what? I just don't understand how someone with such a huge following would literally sit down in front of their camera and plagiarize someone's content, record it, sit down and edit it, sit down and upload it on YouTube, and throughout this entire long ass process to get the video on YouTube, you were like, yeah, this is fine. This is perfect. What do you mean? No one's gonna be upset. No one's gonna know it's HeyParis' video. Even though I'm titling it the same exact thing that HeyParis titled it, like, it's gonna be fine. What? When people tell story times, they're talking about their real life experiences, things that they've gone through, whether it's funny, it's educational, something to learn from, sad, whatever the case may be. That's for them. It's their story to tell. It doesn't make sense to me for someone to tell my story that I've already told on the same platform that it's already told on. It's not like I uploaded my story 3 years ago on YouTube and you're retelling it on Twitter. That's still wrong, but like, if anyone wants to know my story, they can go on my channel and watch my story, because it's my story, it's my experience, and it's available to the public. I don't get it. And the thing that was really weird and low-key scary for me was the fact that she was like, oh, I have to put my hair up for this one. This is not a story time that you're gonna learn something from. Like, what?
Literally had to pull my hair back because I just feel like I need to express myself. This is not one of those stories where you learn a lesson.
Like, she was really acting as if this was her experience. Did she even work at Sephora? Probably not. And like I said, a lot of people thought that this was a collaboration with me and her. So let me state it one more time. I don't know this person. I've never seen their videos, never seen their face. They might be a big YouTuber with 13.4 million subs. I don't know them. I just don't. And that's no shade towards her. I'm just trying to prove my point that this was not a collaboration. She's never reached out to me. She's never emailed me, never DM'd me. She doesn't follow me on Twitter, Instagram, or subscribe to my YouTube. So it's so weird how she remembers and knows my story time word for word and is able to summarize it for her channel. You can't take someone's content and make money from someone else's content and someone else's experience. It's just not right. It's not right. You're getting paid for my experience. Like, that's some real money hungry type shit. If you're out of ideas, if you can't think of what you need to upload, if you feel like you're drying up, whatever the case may be, your last resort should be stealing from someone else's content. Then again, if that's the case, maybe you want me to upload this video. Maybe you want my subscribers to go over to your video and give you more views so that you make more money and whatever the case may be. So I know I'm wearing something different, but I'm editing this video and I actually have a lot more to say than what I said in the video. So please excuse me if I change in and out of costumes because my mind is racing. So not only is she making money off of my video, but she also shamelessly plugged her makeup collaboration to make even more money. Like, this is getting greedy. Hella greedy.
You know, I will go as far as saying that if the MAR and Too Faced palette would have been available back in the day, I would have beat my face with that.
I also did some research on this MAR character just to find out that she's the same YouTuber who did going to the worst makeup artist in my area type video and saying that this small business gave her an eye infection and they have salmonella in a jar and calling their setting spray salmonella spray. Like, that's not even funny. Like, on a comedic standpoint, it's not even like, I wouldn't even giggle. And I urge you guys to look up that story about her because it is so sad. It is so sad that someone with such a big platform would go to those lengths to try and diminish someone's company and claim that this is what really happened and yada, 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 when it's obviously all for views. And I understand some YouTubers work like that. They'll do anything for a click, but that's just the shit that I don't respect. And I needed to say it. But I'm definitely, definitely filing a copyright claim because this is 100% my shit. So let me just say one more time. I was not credited until she got called out. One more time. I was not credited until she got called out. And even then, even if you credit me, you need my permission to tell my story. You never tried to reach out to me on any platform in any way. And it is very easy to get in contact with me because my emails are on all of my platforms. So this was almost like a spit in the face. It was almost like, your content, I'm gonna take what I want from you, make money off of it, and the only time I'm ever gonna credit you is if I get called out. Because if you really wanted to show homage and let people really know that this was my story and you're just reiterating it or you're just retelling it, even though that makes no sense, why are you retelling someone else's story? It doesn't make any sense. You would have said that in video. You would have verbally said it in the video, hey guys, this is not my story. This story is actually by HeyParis. Check out her YouTube channel in the link down below. You didn't say that. So to me, this is malicious and it's disrespectful. I would never take someone's content and not give them credit. I wouldn't take someone's content, period. But this is not like a challenge video that a YouTuber came up with and you're just copying the challenge. No, you're saying my experience word for word. It's weird. It's weird. And then all your subscribers who don't know me are praising you for my experience. I'm seeing people, oh my gosh, this story was so funny. Oh my gosh, like, you're the best storyteller ever. Huh? Baby girl, you know you wrong. If you're a fan, that's completely fine. Just verbally state that. I said I was gonna keep it professional. I'm trying my best. I'm trying my best, y'all. And then to put the cherry on top of everything, at the end of the video, she was like, if you want me to tell your story, email me, or something like that. I didn't email you. You got no permission from me to tell my story. I didn't ask you to tell my story. I didn't contact you in any way. I've never spoken to you in my life, baby. Not once, not even once. So you wrong. So to me, at the end of the video, it's like, now it's seeming like we collaborated. Now it's seeming like I reached out to you and I was like, hey, tell my story. That never happened, never. Somar, if you're watching this, you have 24 hours to delete that video or else I'm filing a copyright claim on you, because at the end of the day, that's what it is. And I don't wanna do that because I know how hard it is for us as YouTubers to build our channel and how hard we work on our content. Well, how hard I work on my content. I don't know about other people, but I don't wanna file a copyright claim on you. I don't wanna give you a copyright strike, but if 24 hours passes and it's not deleted, that's what I'm gonna have to do, because at the end of the day, that's exactly what it is. Now, I've just been informed by Twitter that the video has been deleted, which makes me wonder, if you didn't think what you were doing was wrong, why is the video deleted? Why did you delete the video? It's a good thing I downloaded it, because if I ever need receipts, it's right there on my computer. It's also been brought to my attention that you made a video before this video saying that you want subscribers to send in their stories so you could retell them.
And what I thought would be fun to do is to have, of course, my stories, but also your stories. So I have this email right here set up and you guys can send stories there and I can just kind of tell the stories. I personally love just like listening to story times or watching videos about story times when I'm cooking or when I'm doing my makeup or whenever. So I feel like this will just be a really fun way to interact. You guys can send in your stories and I can just share them. And I already have some stories that I want to share with you guys, and what I'm going to do is just kind of tell the story and of course give credit to the person that shared the story or that originally told the story or that wrote it, you know, so that way we can have fun but also give credit where credit is due, because I think that's so important. So yeah, let me know if you guys like this idea. Maybe it's a terrible idea.
Except for I'm not a subscriber and I didn't tell you to tell my story. So what's going on? It's also been brought to my attention that you said that the next story that you're gonna upload after that video was gonna be your own. But it wasn't your own. It was mine. Can someone explain that to me? Anyone? Hello? Hello? And if any of Mars subscribers are watching this and you want a cape for her and you want a ride for her or whatever the case may be, remember, everyone watching this, hold your favorite YouTubers accountable. If I do some dumb shit, hold me accountable. If your favorite YouTuber does something that you know is wrong beyond any reasonable doubt, call them out, hold them accountable. Not only is the video deleted, but we have an explanation? All within an hour of me posting on my story that I'm about to upload this video. Surprising, not really. She said on our Instagram story, hey guys, I decided to take today's video down since some of you weren't liking the idea of retelling other stories. I had mentioned in my Sunday video I would do this and would 100% be giving credit, which I did, to the original creator, which you didn't. You gave me credit after the fact. And again, I did not give you permission at all to tell my story. So I don't understand what you're not getting. You guys seem really excited, so I figured I would try it out, but I don't think I will continue. I think that's a good idea. Please feel free to share your... What? Please feel free to share your stories with me, and I will continue to share the ones you guys send in the marstorytime@gmail.com. So you're contradicting yourself. Are you going to continue this or are you not? Because you just said, I don't think I'm going to continue. Send me your stories so I can... Girl. So that was an explanation as to why the video has been taken down. There was no apology to me. She still hasn't reached out to me via DM, via email, via anything. She has never spoken to me in her life. She has not apologized to me. She has not explained herself to me. All she's doing is explaining to her subscribers why the video is no longer there. This is crazy. Absolutely insane. I am absolutely flabbergasted. Like, I can't... What? Like, I know I'm good at telling stories, but like, to steal the entire concept? What? I'm scared. I'm terrified. I don't want any hate being sent her way. That is not what I made this video for. I just want to speak my mind. I just want to speak my truth. I was very irritated and I wanted to let it out, and that's how I do it, by making videos. All these bitches is my sons. Now I'ma go and get some bibs for them. Anyways, guys, don't ever let shit slide. That's a lesson for today. Don't ever let shit slide. If something bothers you, speak up. That's all I gotta say.
Hey, you bitches can never be me. Nope, you bitches can never be me. Nope, you bitches can never be me. You bitches can never be me. You bitches can never be me. Nope, yo. You can't screenshot a bitch like me. You can't paste me. You can't copy. You look dumb now, bitch. Floppy. You bitches can never be me. And I peep it and I just laugh because it's funny how you think that you can be me. Bitch, I kiki. You bitches can never be me. 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 Nope. You bitches can never be me. Bitches weird, weird. Need a checkup. Going broke. Just trying to catch up. I'm the main course, bitch. You catch up. You bitches can never be me.